We're going to be streaming the Church of the Dark Star this morning. I'm going to have to mute the game sound temporarily until it actually starts. The church service should have begun already, but it should be starting shortly. Now, the funny thing about Amber Raine is actually talking about the fact that right here is a chaos or a virtue statue, and this is the Church of the Dark Star, and she is all about the chaos. So someone obviously played a little joke on her. She is actually playing TLC's Chasing Waterfalls, so I cannot enable the game audio yet. So that way we can rebroadcast this later. Now this service is all going to be all about the water.org charity event that is going on right now.
AvatarsRadio.org is all about bringing clean drinking water to those that would otherwise go without. Their mission statement is simple, but their goal and desires are unsurmountable. It is a mountain so great that they cannot do it alone. Yet, it will help a world of people who may otherwise never know the joy in which lasting change. A vision to bring safe water and dignity of a toilet for all in our lifetime. It is said that Gary White and Matt Damon co-founded Water.org, a nonprofit organization that has transformed hundreds of communities around the world by providing access to safe water and sanitation. Water.org traces its roots back to the founding of Water Partners International in 1990. In July 2009, Water Partners merged with H2O Africa, resulting in the launch of Water.org. Water.org works with local partners to deliver innovative solutions for long-term success. Its microfinance-based water credit initiative is pioneering sustainable giving in the sector. I really want you all to enjoy your life, and more importantly, you should want to truly enjoy your life. Today we're going to share what I believe is a key component that we all need to fully experience the blessing of happiness. We're going to talk about today the joy and the power of giving. Now it is no secret that by and large we're all inherently selfish and self-centered. Until we learn better, and if you do not believe me, just watch your babies and your children when you don't give them what they want. You will instantly see that we do not need to learn selfishness. We are born with it. Babies are beautiful creations of life, but with such a great gift, selfishness is a part of their package. However, as life goes on, we can learn that there is a warming glow to the heart when we learn to be givers. I'm not just talking about at offering time in a church or when people come begging to you because they have fallen hard on their luck. I'm talking about living to give. I'm talking about always looking for opportunities. What? Oh, yes. I said looking for opportunities. Listen, giving to those that are suffering, to those that have less than us, or are doing something that we enjoy but take for granted is not something we should need to be talked into doing. It is most certainly not something that anyone will or should force a person to do. But we should get to a point where we enjoy giving and making other people happy so much that we look for the opportunities to give. You may have heard of this principle in your life. On either side of the rift, this principle is one that we have heard in many walks of life, and that is sowing and reaping. And I'm not merely talking about the tailors and farmers amongst us. Seriously, it is really a wonderful thing when you learn the power of it, because it is basically states, if you want something, all you need to do is give some of it, and it will come back to you threefold in a harvest. So naturally, if you need financial help, the best way to get it is to give some finances. Where you give it, you sow it into something that will help others, so they can turn around and grow to be able to help you. So springs forth charity drives. It is not to pressure you into giving, but to offer you the opportunity to look at what you have and what you need, and opens the choice to be a little less selfish and a lot more giving to those in need. You will see that one of the things, and it is may not even be most important things that you will get back, is more of the finances that you need in your life. But along with that, we have joy, we're kinder, We can feel better about ourselves. I believe it affects our families. It most certainly affects those that are downtrodden and suffering without things we may take for granted. There are so many great things that happen with the power of giving. Give and gifts will be given to you. For the measure you deal out, it will be measured back to you by 3 times. I love that. How can I not? How can you not? Do to others and it will be done to you in multiples of 3. What an awesome thing that is. If I need friends, then I can be friendly and I will get friends. If I need encouragement, I can encourage other people and pretty soon I will start to get encouraged. Heck, here is something absolutely free and we all have one. We all can give it. The easiest thing to give is your smile. I'd like everyone to try this just right now. Turn to the person next to you here, and those that are listening on the radio or later on SoundCloud, turn to the person next to you and smile at them. A sincere, happy smile. Most often than not, they're going to smile back at you. Try it. Now, granted, there are a few sourpusses in the world who will not smile back at you, and they'll just tilt their head and look at you suspiciously. But the majority of people will smile back at you, and it's free. Everyone likes free. This whole thing about sowing and reaping can now be brought back to the farmers. We have something to thank them for that they are teaching us. As long as this world remains, there will be a time for seeding and a time for harvest. When you plant your seed, you have your seed. It is there in your possession. But in order to get a harvest out of that seed, you need to give up that seed. Am I right? That seed is not going to do anything sitting in your hand or remaining left in its pouch. Now I can see the look on your faces, and yes, I am experiencing this myself. Sometimes it's very scary. You may think, well, I know I have this, but I do not know what I'm going to get if I give this up. What if it doesn't grow at all, and I'm left with nothing? Sometimes it can be even more frightening because you have just put that seed in the ground. I'm, of course, talking about a real seed here, not talking about putting anything else in the ground that would be slightly pointless unless it belongs in the ground. You put that seed in the ground and then nothing. 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 That there is the testing time. You continue to water that seed, and we water it with our words. We continue to let the sun shine on that seed, and after some time, we will see it grow. It is a fantastic experience, and if you do not believe me, go out to the garden. Everything in that garden started with a seed. You can also see it in our everyday lives, in all kinds of ways. Now this may come as a surprise to many, but I challenge you to find out if I am right or not. I would like for someone, anyone, to prove me wrong. And this is why I send out challenges every week. I would like someone to prove me wrong. I challenge everyone to go out there and look for an opportunity to give. Whether it is the water.org charity drive, the WGN Alive Inside charity drive, or if it is even closer to us all, and is the giving to Portalarium to help us build this world we live in. Give to your neighbor here, or just anyone, or anything. I challenge you to seek out an opportunity to give to anyone or anything and see what happens. I bet you will find that it will do something amazing in you. Something beautiful will open up inside you when you open up your heart and you want to make someone else's life better. Not because you want something from it. Not because you expect to get anything in return. but sincerely give just for the joy and the power in giving and seeing someone else being happy. I believe that anytime we give, we're taking advantage of an opportunity that is right in front of us. As some of you know, perhaps more of you that I am even aware of know, that I am one of the most giving people. I will give until there's nothing left to give, just to see happiness in others is met before my own. You may also be aware that when I say something, I mean it. And I am fairly blunt and straightforward with my words and opinions. I'm going to state this right now. We really are not doing this today to get anyone to send anyone offerings. We are not going to look down our noses at you if you don't go out and buy up the water.org donation rewards on the add-on store. Or go over to WGN Alive Inside and pick up the bundle. We're not going to think bad thoughts if you believe that which you enjoy should be kept free to yourself, even if others are paying for it to remain free to you. We are doing this because we believe that giving is one of the most beautiful, amazing, most powerful things that you can choose to do in your life and in the lives of others. My whole purpose is to help you understand the mode of giving and to get you to understand why it is important to give. I think there are a lot of people that just do not understand it. I mean, what I do not understand, and maybe that is where we need to meet in the middle, why would we not give to these things that truly could benefit from it when we will give to other things that are not even that important? We go out and give money for things and then go home and stick it in a drawer and never think of it again. And yet, what we could give to others with that same bit of money, the blessings we could be to others with music, with water, with a smile, the peace and joy we will fill our own hearts with when we see that returned onto us from the same people, why would we not be overly appreciative of that? To want to give because we want other people to have the same joy that we have found. One of the worst things we can do is sit and take and take and take and not give anything back. Can I say something to you today? You may not like me for saying it. You may not even understand why I'm saying it. But I'm going to say it. Free is not always the best plan. I don't really know how much or how long we can appreciate everything that we get if it costs us nothing. Today, I am going to do something again. I am doing it because I believe strongly in it. So strongly that I would give everything I have, including the roof over my own head, for it. I am going to ask you to consider seriously, not just fleetingly, to seek out opportunities where you can give a gift to help with not only the charity for water.org, but also anything else you have found yourself truly appreciating and enjoying in your daily lives. As you enjoy these things, it is right for you to give back what you are being given. I do not enjoy one-sided relationships, and I do not think that you do either. And I hope that what Kazen, myself, and all those involved are doing touches a major part of your life that is really helping you. I'm asking you to help us, not only to keep this happening, but to reach out to other people all over the world that are in need of hope and help. Open your heart with compassion as you realize there are those that sacrifice much more than they will ever have. Whether chaos or order, the virtues and principles of the virtues are ones that should be embraced when considering those less fortunate than yourself. Let truth, love, and courage be your guide, and join us as we help bring clean water to those that may otherwise find dirt in their drinks. Just before I step down here from today, I want to just present to you again the opportunities that are there before you. Choose the door you wish to go through. There are many to choose from. It is more of a blessing to give than to receive. How simple is that? Well, why is that? I mean, let me ask you. How many of you like gifts? Come on. How many of you like it when someone just gives you something? I mean, I know I do. I mean, I really do. So how could it be more of a wonderful feeling to give something than it is to get something? I heard someone say this next thing to me one time, and it made a whole lot of sense to me and answers that question very well. When I receive, I just get this thing. But when I give, I get the joy. And you know, sincerely, what is it we all want when it comes right down to it? Yeah, come on, admit it. What do we all want more than anything else in the world? We all want to be happy. That is the number one thing that people want in their life. It is to be happy. I can tell you straight up that I spent a lot of years as a selfish, self-centered woman, even a selfish, self-centered priestess. And in crying out one day and trying to find out why I was so unhappy, I really did not have anything to be unhappy about. The loudest thing that echoed through my ears was, "You're selfish." So I have purposely learned what I tell everyone I sincerely live by. I live to give. My happiness is in seeing others happy before myself. I live to give. I hope, sincerely hope, that I do not have a day in my life, not one day in my life, where I don't give something to somebody. It may be an item. It may be encouragement. It may be as simple as a smile. I may even give some time. But I spent too many years of my life unhappy to waste one more moment of my life unhappy. So I am encouraging you to be a giver. Live to give. Don't be a dick and live to get. Rise Up Gaming, thank you. Who's Gaming Now? Thank you. Portalarium, thank you. Avatars, 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 thank you. We'll be right back.
Yesterday, but too many storms have come and gone, leaving a trace. I'm not one God to give a praise. It because my life is 10 shades of gray. I pray all 10 fade away, sell the praise for the 7 days. And like this promise is true, only my faith can undo the many chances I believe would bring my life to an end. Clear blue and unconditional skies have dried the tears from my eyes.
Okay, so I just received confirmation for Kaz's part, or Kazen, Phoenix Fire. There is no audio during his sermon, so you can just read along. After this church service is over, the Church of the Dark Star, brought to us by Amber Raine, we'll be heading over to the BMC Crafting Fair. Since there is no audio for Kazen, I'll actually read his. So, we'll get rid of the chasing the waterfalls. So, today is a truly momentous day for many reasons, not least of which is this week. We, avatars who have long since proclaimed to be heroes to the downtrodden, have our chance to do just that. Throughout the tales of in life and the lore of the fabled avatar, we've all been told the avatar's role is to uphold justice and bring peace and safety. Now this day, we have a chance to do that in a very real way. Yet in doing so, and in trying to apply myself to the lines these things bring up and support these things, I heard an interesting comment the other day. I had someone tell me, well, Kazen, what do you get out of this? And why should I help such a thing for someone else when I have to take care of myself? This person told me this, then followed it up by saying those others should be able to take care of themselves the same as we do. This statement threw me for a loop for a moment. I will tell you this in a very direct way. If you are here today, you most likely do not understand the perils that those whom do not possess these things afforded to you go through. Humankind, for the longest time, we evolved in groups, one of the many species on the planet that grew and evolved the concept of family. Not just blood family, but evolving to tribes and village. City and country. This was not just for the sake of posterity. The biological and intellectual evolution of humankind was built off the idea of being empowered through community. Somewhere, somehow, we as a species lost our way. As Amber said it, it is born into us to fight for our own, to be selfish, and to take. But I shall be very clear in saying this to anyone and everyone. You have earned nothing on your own in this life. When we are born, unless you were tossed to the woods and left for dead only to survive and claw your way to be here today, then you had someone at some point, probably for years on end, take care of you and help you. You had parents and teachers, bosses, friends, girlfriends, pets, and mentors alike. Without them taking their time to take care of you, you would not be here. Yet in other parts of the world, there are those that, quite frankly, are suffering. There are children and people who do not have parents, not because they were forgotten, but because they did not survive. We bring to your attention this week the first of many charitable drives to help the Portalarium community, and the strength in giving and love we all share for each other and fellow man. And we bring it forward because this community and everything we do for each other embodies the very spirit which we should all feel about all of mankind. Charity is not about money. You do not have to have money to participate. You do not have to be rich to help. Money is a byproduct of an idea. If you are poor and have no money to give this day, then that does not mean you cannot help others. Tell others about the problems, the cause. Tell them about those who suffer and find those who can help. Lend your support, your links on your websites, your time, your voice, and your heart. If you are here today playing this game, you are likely doing so in the comfort of a home that is powered, heated, or has AC on a computer that costs the yearly wage of someone in other places. It is these very people that we who know the luxuries we possess are trying to reach out and touch the lives of. And through Rise Up Gaming's drive alone, I can tell you that the alliance between Rise Up Gaming and Soda's community together, we have earned enough this week to bring sanitized and safe water to over 200 people across the world. In 1 week, we, this group here and those around us, and all of those who pitched in some way have helped 200 people in a week. while we build this great community world of ours, this community and the many things to come for New Britannia, let us look back to the earth and remember there's always something more we can do. I appreciate everyone's time and their support. Thank you. We would like to thank Brother Kazan and Amber Raine. For this week's church service, and Amber is telling us that Rise Up Gaming, thank you. Who's Up Gaming? Who's Gaming Now? Thank you. Portal Aram, thank you. Avatars, thank you. And the person sitting right beside me, Kazuto Kirigawa, leads the Rise Up Gaming branch dedicated to Shroud of the Avatar. He is also known as Lolly on Twitch. And we really must thank Kazan Phoenixfire for actually organizing the Shroud of the Avatar stream team and bringing a bunch of new streamers on under a streaming initiative. The streaming initiative is a little bit different than the mission statement for New Britannia News Network, where we are just reporting on the news in the world of New Britannia, and we welcome their input. And Rise Up Gaming will be starting their streamathon. It's going to be 10 hours of Shroud of the Avatar action. And currently the streamathon that Kazuto's undertaking is actually in support of water.org, and Shroud of the Avatar jumped on, or Portalarium, the parent company that's behind Shroud of the Avatar, jumped on board and started adding some in-game items that you can purchase off the store to support water.org for Rise Up Gaming. Who's Gaming Now initiative. So we've got a few words from Lolly, or Kazuta. So, twitch.tv/riseupgaming, in about 15 minutes or so, we'll have 10 hours of uninterrupted streaming of Shroud of the Avatar. There will be a variety of people actually doing the stream, so please show the community some love and appreciation. And they are definitely enjoying the game. Some of them have actually made it their game of choice. They do come from a variety of other games as well. They do love supporting indie gamers. as Kazuto is saying right there, we freaking love this game. Lolly's thanking everybody for the support. He hopes to see you on his stream. We really love Lolly and wish him the best. And we hope that the water.org charity drive from Rise Up Gaming actually exceeds your expectations. Amber Raine has one more announcement to make before we joint go over to the BMC Crafting Fair. Reeled of Relics by Reeled has just submitted this. They will be creating an area of their store. So relicsbyreeled.com, I believe, is the domain name. That's relicsbyreeld.com. They're going to be creating a section of their store where those shirts will actually end up going to water.org, and they're going to be the same design as the in-game cloaks. That is actually really cool. I think I'll have to go over there and buy one of those myself. Now, Reeled is actually the one that's responsible for doing a bunch of the coins that are currently out there, as well as the Shot of the Avatar shot glass, the beer pint glass, some caps, some beanies, and some other things. I think he's also the one that makes the shirts that are actually worn in the Shot of the Avatar office as well.
So how is the Church of the Dark Star going?
It is nearly over. There's a final statement by Amber, and she should be dismissing us to go on to the crafting fair in just a moment.
Alrighty, I'm at the crafting fair. Lump Dizzle's out here. We got a nice crowd starting to form. We just got confirmation of two guest speakers at the BMC convention in October in Austin.
Well, who are those speakers going to be?
Chris Spears and Starlong will be there.
That is awesome. That will be.
That is absolutely awesome.
Yes, it is.
We will revisit that when I go on the air.
Yes. So we are almost out of here. I'm going to be cutting the video while we're doing some of the information at the BMC Craft Fair. And the BMC Craft Fair is actually going to be taking place in Owl's Head. And Amber Raine is going to be hosting a dance party at the lot next door. Okay, I'm going to end this stream and I'm going to